I can't.
Can't? Or won't?
My dear girl, I am the host.
Bates, have you seen my husband anywhere?
Not for the last few minutes, madam, no. But I think you would like to know there's a gentleman in the garden.
In the garden?
The colonial gentleman.
Are you hiding, Mr. Easton?
Mr. Darrell, I do apologize. You must think me awfully rude. I didn't mean...
It's perfectly all right.
I was admiring the magnolia.
It's too dark to see it properly. I'm rather proud of it.
I wouldn't have thought that...
But I would have known a magnolia from a marrow.
I wasn't going to say that.
No, I know you wouldn't have said it, but you might have thought it.
This room is a little unexpected. Is it yours?
It's mine. My private retreat.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to trespass.
Not many of my husband's friends are interested in gardens or flowers or trees.
It's a fine specimen, difficult to cultivate in this country.
Oh, not really. They simply need care. Pruning can be a problem. You cut too close, and the wound will never heal. The tree will die. I'm sorry, I'm boring you.
I was fascinated. To tell the truth, I was hiding. I'm not much of a partygoer, Mrs. Darrell, but of a fish out of water. It's not just the starched shirt and the black tie.
No.
It's all this. Cocktails, small talk, all the latest gossip. I mean, I feel rather out of it. What does one say?
One talks about the weather, money, cricket, the latest fashion.
Yes, I know. I mean, that is a jolly pretty frock you're wearing.
Oh, please don't. My husband asked me to be especially nice to you.
But to me? Why?
I don't know. Are you important, Mr. Easton?
Me? I'm not important at all. Why do you ask?
Then you're not one of Richard's money men.
Richard?
My husband.
Of course, Darrell. No, I'm not one of his money men. I grow oranges. Yeah, I know that must sound a bit odd, just like that, in the middle of London.
Oranges?
In the Transvaal. I used to be an accountant. Then after the war, I couldn't settle, so I went to South Africa. Bought myself a plantation, turned into a farmer.
Are you a successful farmer?
Comparatively. I've just bought the plantation that runs alongside mine. I bought it from Darrell, actually, your husband.
Richard.
Richard.
And are you happy?
Well, I'd never regretted it. Of course, it can get pretty lonely out there sometimes.
Must be very beautiful. The orange blossom.
Yes. The magnolia is more delicate, as you said. Vulnerable.
Pity it's so dark. You ought to see it in daylight.
Yes, I'd like to.
Come tomorrow afternoon, can you?
I don't want to be a nuisance, Mrs. Darrell.
Please, nobody ever calls me Mrs. Darrell. It's Theo.
Theo.
Theodora.
My name is Vincent.
I do hope you don't think I was laughing at you about growing oranges.
Of course not.
Yes, Bates?
The minister's party has vacated the dining room, madam, and appears to be about to leave. The minister seems a little agitated.
Oh, dear. Will you excuse me?
It's time I went to.
Bates, find Mr. Darrell and warn him.
You will permit me to say, young man, you just don't know what you're talking about.
I may not, but the governor does, and he's really steamed up about it. He's threatening to come up to the house and actually speak. He hasn't done that since Lloyd George's ridiculous pension bill.
Doubtless the house will survive the honour. Ah, oh, my dear Mrs. Darrell.
Minister.
What's your view, Theo?
Now, how can I have a view unless I know what you're talking about?
Well, changing the prayer book, of course. Willoughby here doesn't seem to think it's a serious matter.
Well, some of us in the house do. Some of us take our moral and spiritual responsibilities seriously.
Oh, I take it very seriously. I mean, what about the jolly old marriage service? Vanessa and I want to know what we're letting ourselves in for.
They couldn't change the marriage service. Love, honor, and obey. Well, they couldn't change that, could they, Theo?
No, they couldn't change that.
But it's ridiculous, some of it. I mean, with this body ivy worship, I don't care what you say.
Thank you, Bates. Presently.
I can't believe Parliament is going to give time to this. Not in this session, anyway.
The marriage service is at the root of the British way of life. It's not a subject to be treated lightly.
Lightly? Well, of course it's not.
Charlie, you're being terribly naughty. Imogen, take him away and try and make a happier, if not wiser, young man of him.
Yes, come on, you old boar. We've outstayed our welcome. Many apologies, Theo.
I didn't mean that at all. You know, you're always welcome.
Why is young man such a demeaning expression?
You're not going already, Minister.
The opera, I'm afraid.
Ah. The arts, you know. Yes. See, I'm an imperfect Wagnerian.
It's
very
big.
What
are you
coming
on quite?
Didn't you, darling?
Perhaps. You must.
None of the family.
I'll see you later.
Theo?
Excuse me.
I have to go out. Things to discuss with old Jaggers. Business?
Would you like me to clear your study for you?
No. Jaggers wants me to meet Mrs. Hamilton's cousin, who came into $250,000 earlier this year and doesn't know what to do with it.
I understand.
I'm sorry. Well, people seem to have enjoyed themselves, but I do wish they'd go away.
Oh, don't be silly, Richard. You can't put a time limit on a cocktail party.
More is the pity. I do. Let me.
My dear Theodora, it's been delightful. Only one thing spoilt it. Why do you have to be quite so happily married? It gives the chap no hope. No hope at all.
Colonel Jaggers, you're a terrible flirt. He is, isn't he, Theo?
I think he's rather an accomplished one.
Aren't you coming with us, Mrs. Darrell? I'm sure my cousin would be delighted.
Poor old Theo's got to man the fort. Usual hangers-on to be dealt with. Trouble with some people, you invite them for cocktails, they never know when to leave.
I think you'd better find your coat, my dear.
If you manage to get rid of the remainder and feel like coming on, we'll probably end up at Crags.
I don't think so. I think perhaps I'll have an early night.
Oh, and by the way, what happened to Easton?
He left.
Without saying goodnight.
He said goodnight to me. Perhaps you were occupied.
Dash it, Theo. I purposely asked you to be especially nice to him.
I was nice to him, Richard.
Oh, come along, Richard. You know very well your adorable good lady is especially nice to everyone. The perfect hostess. Good night, my dear. Now, are we all ready?
Indeed, we are. You're going in presence.
Oh, don't wait up for me, darling.
Follow us.
Good night, Mrs. Hamilton.
Bye.
Good night, Mrs. Darrell.
You're early, sir.
Early or late, difference it make?
Shall I get you some tea, sir?
No, you can bring me a brandy and soda.
Very good, sir.
Where's Mrs. Darrell?
In the garden, sir.
Where else?
With Mr. Easton, sir.
Easton?
Yes, sir.
Evening papers arrived.
On your desk, sir.
Dorset.
Shall I inform Mrs. Darrell that you've returned, sir?
No, I don't think so.
Very good, sir.
I'm a country girl at heart. But that's my special bride.
Thea.
No. No.
I must say something.
No.
Thea.
Don't speak, please. Don't ask me anything.
Oh, my dear, have you seen Quentin Harbour? Theo, my dear, have you seen Quentin Harbour? Not for ages. Oh, how terrible, my dear.
How did you do it? Come on, own up. How did you do it?
Well, I sort of said, will you?
And I sort of said, yes.
That's no way to propose. You young people haven't the faintest notion of how these things ought to be done.
Have you, Colonel Jaggers?
Ah, give them the right sauce of inspiration, dear lady. Dear lady, you are my love, my dream, my destiny, the captain of my heart. Will you be mine?
Stop making love to my wife, Jaggers. Oh.
That was beautifully done, Colonel. Gentlemen,
but no one ever accepted.
I've had a quick look at your ledgers, old chap. Of course, they're more your province than mine, but they seem perfectly all right to me.
Then why has the minister sent his apologies? Why isn't he coming to dinner?
Well, you know what politicians are. Meetings, committees, probably been offered a better meal somewhere else. I'll get Bates to bundle this lot up for you. You can take them with you when you go home.
Right.
Lovely to see you again, Mrs. Howard.
You haven't met my cousin, Jack Anderson, have you? Oh,
glad you could make it, Anderson.
He doesn't look like a man with a quarter of a million, does he?
Young fool, invested in some South African mining shares. You'll lose the lot.
Which is hardly
surprising.
He's a very boring man.
It's a really hot summer.
And so
I can take any amount of
sunshine. It burns poor me to an absolute frazzle.
Young people, none of you has any idea what real is like. Out in India, it's dry season. My word.
I thought you took to the hills when it became too hot.
No, in fact, the men's farms are hot country right enough. Though, mind you, some of the dear ladies wouldn't go over them.
Is this an indiscreet story coming on, Colonel Jaggers?
The very rum things went on in the heat, I can tell you. Very rum.
Scandal.
Oh, my lips are sealed.
Unseal them, do.
Heat plays funny tricks. Some chaps, well, goes to their head.
I don't think that's what the Colonel had in mind, Vanessa. What about the women, the ones who refused to move out?
Well, they are, you see. No names, no pactual, of course. But I could tell a tale or two. I remember it must have been about 1907. There was one particular lady.
It is fit lady.
Doesn't bear so thinking about, does it?
The old school.
Was I surprised that?
Regimental commander squad, Amity.
Army wives can be very peculiar. Oh, say my brother tells me.
The fact is, she suddenly developed an almighty passion for the Viceroy's ADC, who was seconded to the garrison. Everyone knew about it. Can't keep that sort of thing quiet. The grand passion, everybody called it.
How romantic. Grand passions don't happen nowadays.
Oh, thank you very much.
You know what I mean. Rudolph Valentino, that sort of thing. Well, I think everyone ought to have one grand passion in their lives.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you think, Claire?
How about an average passion with a very large bank balance?
The whole thing ended in tragedy, of course. Fellow shot himself. ADC, not the Viceroy.
Ladies, I think perhaps we might take coffee in the library.
Yeah. These things happen, you know. Worse for the woman, I dare say, but a bit beyond me. Never could fathom this love business.
hiding again, Mr. Easton?
Not hiding. Waiting.
Waiting.
For you. I knew you'd come.
I shouldn't have, really. I didn't want to.
Didn't you?
This isn't possible. It mustn't. We mustn't.
My dear, darling, dearest Theo. I love you. I'm sorry, I'll go.
Just for a moment. In the tunnel, I was afraid.
No, I was the one who was afraid. Waiting for you at the station, I thought you might have changed your mind.
No, I couldn't have done that.
I hardly dared let myself believe.
I'd promised. I think perhaps I'm afraid of happiness.
You deserve it so very much, my darling. And we'll find it. Together.
Reserve compartment, first class, 14A, Mr. Mrs. Easton. Excuse me, sir, madam.
That's quite all right.
The tickets, please, sir.
Oh.
Afternoon, Mrs. Easton.
Singles for Dover.
Thank you, sir. Taking the night ferry, sir?
No, tomorrow morning.
Glasses set, fair, sir. It should be a quiet crossing.
Do you think we're having a grand passion?
Very grand. Very passionate.
I never could fathom this love business.
Calm enough.
It's a calm sea and a smooth passage.
Are you a good sailor? I never thought to ask.
The sea doesn't frighten me.
Even though you're a country girl?
Even though I'm a country girl.
So I'll put it on the table, will you? Thank you, that'll do.
I used to think that being a country girl was the end of the world. So dull, so tedious. I married Richard mainly to get away from all that tranquility, all that safety.
You didn't ever love him?
I don't think I knew the meaning of the word. I liked the glamour and excitement of his world. It was so different.
He?
Oh, Richard married me for my money. Oh. No, that's not quite fair. I suppose Richard loved me
loves me as much as he can. As much as he can love anybody.
You're not regretting this?
I've made my decision. I've turned my back on all that.
You're very brave. The scandal.
Oh, it'll be a 9 days wonder, that's all. Oh, Colonel Jaggers will add it to his repertoire of dinner party stories, I dare say. Theo Darrell, who ran off with that dashed orange grower from the Transvaal. Colonial bounder, what?
You're very unkind. You won't get afternoon tea on the plantation, you know. Not unless you teach Eliza how to make it. Eliza is my housekeeper, black as the ace of spades and a heart of gold. Of course, it can get pretty lonely out there sometimes. What is it? Big city crash, failure of Imperial and Overseas Trust. What does it matter?
Richard is Imperial and Overseas Trust.
Well, that doesn't have to affect us.
Read it. Read it all.
A receiver has been appointed to wind up the affairs of the well-known land investment company. It is understood that financial experts from Scotland Yard's fraud squad are investigating the company's activities. And there are rumours of serious allegations to follow. Managing Director Richard Darrell was today unavailable to comment. What are you doing?
I must go to him.
Don't be absurd.
He's my husband. I must go to him.
For God's sake.
Don't you see? This means ruin. I can't choose today of all days to leave him.
Bates! Bates! Where the hell are you? Theo? Theo?
I'm sorry, sir.
Where's Mrs. Darrell?
She's not at home, sir.
Well, I realize that, you fool. Where is she?
She left this afternoon, sir.
What can you do? What possible difference can it make whether you're with him or not?
Possibly none.
Then why?
I'm his wife.
Well, this is ridiculous. You just admitted you don't love him.
Love has nothing to do with it.
She must have said where she was going.
No, sir.
Did you take anything with her?
Some luggage, sir.
How much luggage?
2 suitcases, sir.
All right, Bates. Bates, I don't want to see or speak to anyone this evening, anyone at all. Do you understand?
Very well, sir.
Leave it. Wait. Wait until the morning. Oh, my dearest love.
He needs me.
I need you.
No good. I must go to him.
Wouldn't have believed it, not of you. You encourage a man. You lead him on. You keep him on a string. For the excitement of it, the sense of power it gives you, I suppose. And then when you reach the point of no return, you cut and run back to your ever-loving husband. No, then prove it.
You must think what you will of me. I can only say this. I love you, and I will always love you, but I'm married to Richard. He needs me. I must go back to my husband.
Thank God you've turned up.
I heard the news. How bad is it?
About as bad as possible.
Tell me.
Well, in a nutshell, my darling, Imperial and Overseas is washed up. Finished. Oh, it's happening all the time. post-war depression, they call it. Just because our business is mainly in the colonies, nobody could have expected us to be immune.
The papers said something about serious revelations with the fraud squad.
Oh, that's rubbish. The usual press speculation. Anyway, they can't touch your money. That's one good thing. And the house is in your name, too. On the other hand, things won't be quite the same anymore.
No.
At least I've got you.
Yes.
Theo, I don't know what I'd do without you.
Well, if there's anything I can do to help.
Bring me another brandy. There's a good girl.
Richard, I didn't hear you.
You were miles away.
Yes.
Or you wish you were.
Of course I don't.
Yes, well, you're lucky. You've got your precious garden to help keep your mind off this mess. You can just carry on, water the plants, prune the roses, open this damn thing to cut back a bit.
What is it, Richard?
Jaggers was taken up this morning.
The Colonel?
My honourable and gallant colleague has been arrested. Cooking the books, they say. Naturally, it's assumed I knew all about it.
And did you?
Well, that, my dear, is the least of our worries.
Don't you think you ought to tell me everything? The whole truth?
My dear Theo, what possible good can it do to go through all the tedious details with you?
If I'm going to help, I ought to know.
What makes you think I need your help?
It's not a question of need. I'm your wife.
Sit down. I don't know that you'll be able to follow all this. It's a bit technical. Business practice, you know.
The Colonel's been arrested. I can understand that.
Well, that's nothing. It's incompetence, really. I would never have brought him in to begin with.
Will you be blamed?
For his errors? Oh, no, no. My problem, our problem, is quite different. You see, in the business, buying and selling land, sometimes it's necessary to use unorthodox methods, and sometimes there's a conflict.
Between right and wrong?
Well, I'm not talking right and wrong. I'm talking of technicalities. The conflict between what is a technical business matter and what is a crime. Now, to an outsider, it's sometimes difficult to spot the difference.
Richard, please don't treat me like a child. Either you committed a crime or you haven't.
You would see it like that, wouldn't you? Everything has to be either black or white with you.
I'm sorry. Please try to explain. I do want to understand.
Most of our dealings, imperial and overseas, I mean, are in the colonies. We buy and sell land. Yeah. Farms, estates, mines, plantations. Now, sometimes it's not in the best interests of Imperial and Overseas to be seen to be involved in a particular deal, so we act through nominees. Sometimes I've had to pretend to be a private person rather than a trust managing director.
To pretend?
Or to sign certificates of transfer for land property in my own name.
Richard Darrell?
Yes.
When they belonged to the company?
Well, when the company had originally financed the purchase. The company would always be reimbursed in full.
After the sale?
It's standard procedure to avoid unacceptable profits for the trust. It's all above board, looked at in a certain light. But to an auditor, perhaps, it could seem fishy, as if I'd been milking the trust for my own personal profit.
Have you?
Didn't lose out on the deals, if that's what you mean. You hardly call that a crime.
Some people might.
Some people might. Auditors, Scotland Yard ferrets. It's a technicality, of course. It's trivial, but it could be serious.
How serious?
If a transfer was unearthed, bearing my name on it, and the property concerned still appeared in the company ledger, it would be difficult to explain. I could go to prison. For a long time.
Richard.
Oh, my dear. It may not come to that. It didn't come out at all.
You've broken the law.
Technically, I broke the law, yes, but only technically.
To cheat? To steal?
Well, I'm not trying to justify what I've done. Don't condemn me out of hand. What I did, Theo, I did for you.
For me?
I know what people say.
About what?
But I married you for your money.
And didn't you?
No, no, I damn well didn't! But when the woman you love has money and you haven't, how on earth do you convince anyone of the truth, let alone her?
What was the truth?
That I loved you then, that I love you now. No one was more surprised than I when you agreed to become my wife. I've never been a rich man, not really rich.
That's not important.
I wanted you to be proud of me. I wanted to treat you the way you deserve. You mean so very much to me.
What can we do?
You mean it? You'll stick by me? With you by my side, there may be a way out of this mess. There may be a way.
Do you have a plan?
The most ghastly thing about this whole business, I feel I betrayed you.
Oh, don't, please.
Of course, I should never have gone into the business. I should have gone in for farming, gone to Africa, bought a plantation, grown oranges. Do you like that, my dearest darling Theo?
What do you mean?
Well, nothing.
I'll go and change.
Well, we'll talk about it later. At dinner.
I wondered if I might have a word, madam.
I'm sorry, Bates, what did you say?
Well, madam, madam knows that Mr. Darrell, the master, has given me a month's warning. Well, I do appreciate the situation, madam, but I wondered in the circumstances. Well, I've worked for your family nearly all my life, madam. Madam will understand that I shall be most unhappy to leave your employment.
Of course, Bates, I absolutely understand.
If it's a question of economizing in the household or cutting back...
What did you say?
Well, I should be content to accept a reduction in my own remuneration, madam, if from there...
Thank you, Bates. We'll talk about it later, shall we?
Theo... It just struck me. I haven't seen you in that dress for ages. Remember the one you bought in Paris last year?
The Cayo?
Creamy thingamabob. Cost the earth. Put it on tonight.
It's an original.
I know.
But for an evening at home?
Please.
Just the two of us?
For me. Love to see you in it. May as well finish this, darling.
Will that be all, madam?
All right, Bates, that'll do. Cut along now.
Very good, son. Madam?
Richard, is it necessary to be quite so curt with Bates?
He's a servant.
He's an old and trusted servant. Whom you've dismissed without a word to me.
Oh, my dear, you said you wanted to help.
I did, and of course I do.
What does it matter? Eat, drink, and be merry for tomorrow, who knows what.
Don't.
Not funny?
No. I think perhaps I'll cut along now, too.
Oh, not yet. Don't go yet. Got something I want to say. You know, about all this. Things may not be quite as bad as they seem.
No?
And I know I've been a bit on edge tonight, but with Jagger's being taken up, I'm sorry.
I understand.
But we must look on the bright side.
Is there one?
Well, there may be. You see, whatever the police may suspect, there's nothing they can actually prove.
There's no evidence.
Oh, I don't think so. I'm not a fool. I've covered my tracks pretty thoroughly. Cold? The thing is, there are some papers with my name on them. Now, they mean nothing on their own, but if certain people were to get hold of
them... The police?
They might start putting two and two together, and those papers are the one damnable piece of hard evidence that could finish
this. So you're going to destroy them?
Oh, I'd destroy them as fast as I could if they were in my hands. That's the devil of it.
Well, somebody else has them.
Yes, and I'm pretty certain he doesn't know what they mean.
Who?
Easton. Oh, somehow I never seem to have got on really friendly terms with the man, barely got to know him, but he seemed to like you.
He does.
Well, you see what I'm driving at? I've an idea that if you were to go to Easton and ask him for the certificate, I'm sure he wouldn't refuse.
I can't do that.
Too proud to beg, is that it? Even for me?
That has nothing to do with it.
Don't you understand? If this business comes out, you're liable to find yourself married to a jailbird.
Vincent Easton won't use those papers against you. I'm certain of that.
Oh, he may not wish to ruin us, but as long as that certificate of transfer exists, he's a danger to our safety. That paper must be destroyed.
Can't you write to him and explain that you're in difficulties and ask him to return them?
There isn't time. Jagger's in custody. There's no knowing what he might tell the police. He knows nothing, of course, poor fool.
Has he been taken up for what you've done?
Look, this is desperately urgent. I want you to go and see Easton, now.
At this time of night?
We're not living in the Middle Ages.
No, Richard, I will not be bully-ragged.
All you have to do is to see the man, ask him to give you a piece of paper.
I can't!
Theo, darling, I wouldn't ask you to do this if there was any other way.
No.
Look, my dear girl, I know it's a beastly thing to have to do, to beg a favor of someone you hardly know.
That's not the point.
Theo, you said you wanted to help. Now, this is a matter of life and death. You won't let me down. Please.
I can't explain, but there are reasons why I can't do what you ask.
Very well.
Richard, what are you going to do? No. You can't. You mustn't.
You leave me no alternative.
No.
Life or death, I said. Oh, it's very melodramatic, but I mean it, Thea. Disgrace. Ruin. For you too. I can't face that. Better finish it now.
You shan't do it. You can't. No!
If you love me, if you ever love me, please help me. I've no one else to turn to.
I've been trying to write to you all day. I wanted to make one last attempt to get you to change your mind. The words wouldn't come, and now suddenly, miraculously, you're here.
No, you don't understand.
My dearest,
I'm here
love.
On behalf of my husband. My husband thinks... He believes you have some papers in your possession that may do him some harm. I've come to ask you to give them to me.
I don't understand.
A title deed.
Well, I have the deeds of my new plantation, that's all. Title deed, certificate of transfer.
From Richard to you.
Of course, I'd never heard of Imperium overseas. I didn't realize. This is what you came for.
Thank you. Have you a match? When I was a little girl, we used to have a fender just like this in the nursery. A club fender, isn't that what they're called?
The gravest of all nursery crimes was burning papers in the fireplace.
And you did?
Oh, no. I was much too well behaved. We're a very old-fashioned family, see, not really part of the 20th century at all.
Strict discipline.
We simply stuck to the rules, that's all.
What were the rules? Your rules?
Duty, honour, love.
Duty first?
Oh, always.
Before love.
Go back to Africa, back to your plantation, you'll find your happiness.
And you? Go back to your husband and your garden.
I'm needed.
I need you. You're content to act out the rest of your life married to a crook.
I have to.
What sort of a world do you think you're living in? You can't turn your back on reality. All this talk of loyalty is meaningless. You owe no loyalty to a man like that, a man you despise. Think what your life will be like if you stay with him. Every day a reminder of what you turned your back on. Happiness. You talk of duty. Don't you owe a duty to yourself? To that happiness we can make together? Come with me.
I do hope I didn't disturb you calling so late.
May I get you a cab?
No, thank you. I have one waiting.
Shall I come down with you?
No, please don't bother. Good night, Mr. East.
Good night, Mrs. Darrell.
Home again, miss?
No, just go. Anywhere, just keep on driving.
Up so late,
Bates? Not at all, madam.
Here. You've been a long time.
Have I?
A damned long time.
Good night, sir, madam.
Is it all right? You're sure?
I burnt the papers.
With the right papers. Did you look?
No.
But then how do you know?
I'm sure, I tell you. Don't bother me, Richard. I can't bear any more tonight. Don't touch me. I'm sorry. My nerves are all on edge. I simply can't bear to be touched.
I understand.
Do you?
Theo, I'm damn sorry.
What?
Well, I'm sorry if I had to let you in for such a rotten job. I hope there wasn't any unpleasantness.
You don't know, Richard, what this night has cost me.
God, I never met. You did that for me? If I'd have known, I'd die, if I'd realised. Why, I told you I hardly knew the man. But if I'd have guessed, I'd have never asked you to go. Now, please believe me, I never meant that you...
You never meant what? Tell me, what was it that you never meant?
Well, don't let's speak about it. I don't want to know. I don't even want to think about it.
What do you think happened tonight?
Well, it didn't happen. We'll say it didn't happen.
You think he asked a price for those papers?
If I thought he'd do anything like that, behave like that, I never dreamt.
Didn't you? Why did you ask me to wear this dress tonight? Why did you send me there alone so late? You guessed he cared for me. You expected...
I expected nothing.
You planned it. You said you had a plan. You intended this from the very beginning. You knew all along he had those papers, so you planned to save your skin with my body. You meant me to whore for you.
Theo.
Can you deny it?
Theo?
If it gives you any satisfaction, your plan worked. Though not in the way you imagined. There was an element you hadn't bargained for. You see, Vincent and I fell in love.
Fell in love?
A week ago, he asked me to leave you to go away with him, and I agreed.
You're making this up.
It was the day the news broke of the collapse. We were at an hotel in Dover. I happened to see a newspaper. It was pure chance.
Dover?
It seemed to me that I owed you a duty as you were in trouble, so I came back.
Did you go to bed with him?
No. But I wanted to.
Don't believe it.
Why not? You're quite ready to believe that to save you, I'd go to bed with a man I barely knew. Why can't you believe that I'd happily give myself to a man I love?
We'll say no more about it.
Don't you understand the difference?
Is there a difference?
Perhaps there isn't.
I don't want to talk about it. We need never mention it again. I don't understand you, but I can forgive.
I cannot.
What did you say?
I can't forgive you. I was willing to forgive you when I knew you to be a liar and a thief. I suppose I've always known deep down you weren't quite straight with the world. I've forgiven, pretended not to notice your infidelities, your women. I'm not blind,
Richard.
Well, that
isn't the same thing. For a man,
I was prepared to forgive because despite everything, I believed in your love for me. I believed you needed me as a wife.
I do.
What you've done tonight cancels everything.
Don't go, Theo. I do need you.
What for? Who do you want me to sleep with next?
I won't let you go. Where will you go? Back to him?
No, I can't do that.
Theo, I'm all the things you said. I'm worthless. But I do love you.
Richard, I was unfaithful to you, in intention at any rate. For that betrayal, our pain, loneliness. But you betrayed honor and love. You gambled on my sense of duty. You gambled on the thing you loved and lost.
Where are you going?
To a sort of freedom. There's nothing to bind me here.